This is Generation Stadia, giving you that daily dose of everything and anything Stadia related, and today I wanted to talk just a bit about that Mafia controversy that's been going around. But before we dive into that, I actually just want to talk a little bit about SiriusXM 4, as it's been officially announced coming to Stadia and will arrive August. This will mark the newest entry into the series, and I have to say it seems like what they're doing here is pretty much cranking everything up all the way to max and making it crazy. They're implementing something new called the Legion system, and as you can tell by the name, it means you're gonna be facing thousands and thousands of enemies at once. But don't worry, it's not just the enemies that are getting a crazy upgrade, but your arsenal as well. We're talking chainsaw launchers, dual-wielding automatic shotguns, and straight-up cannons. You'll have plenty of options on how to combat the incoming horde, and I'm sure it'll be a blast to do so. Personally, I'm looking forward to the game, and the 4-player co-op is sure to be a fun time with friends. I'm also really looking forward to seeing how they handle so many enemies on screen at once. The previous SiriusXM titles already did a great job at overwhelming you, but this just sounds nuts. And for those of you wondering whether or not you might like this game, well, luckily the SiriusXM collection is still available as a Stadia Pro pickup at the time of this video being posted, so be sure to go check it out. You can bet that SiriusXM 4 will stay true to its roots and provide that same crazy gameplay experience it's provided throughout all of its titles. Either way, let me know what you think of this game and the series down in the comments section below, but for now, let's move on to the Mafia controversy that's going around. So in case you weren't aware, the Mafia Trilogy Collection was announced not that long ago, and recently they allowed the release of both Mafia 2 and 3 on other platforms. Noticeably absent was the Stadia release, despite being announced alongside the rest of the platforms. Understandably so, some people are upset that we didn't get it day and date with the rest because we weren't given any sort of indication that it might or would have been delayed. We didn't hear a single word about it from Google or 2K until after it was released. In the press release for the game, it was clarified that the Stadia version had been delayed due to the COVID-19 situation affecting development. As of right now, the release timing is still to be determined, so we don't exactly know how long this delay will be. Now, I want to give you my thoughts on all of this. Personally, I'm not too disappointed at the fact that it was delayed and didn't release side by side. The reason given sounds very valid to me, and I'm not very skeptical of it considering all the user reports that are coming in from the other platforms. From unstable and inconsistent frame rate to mono audio during cutscenes, it certainly sounds like this game needed just a bit more time to actually iron out all these issues. It certainly had me thinking that this did affect the development process and the porting job they had to do for not just Stadia but all the platforms involved. I also need to make it clear, now that we know these are issues, I'm fully expecting the Stadia version of the game to launch without those issues present. Otherwise, that will disappoint me and many others who are looking forward to playing the game. So, does that mean that I believe both 2K and Google should be let off scot-free without any complaints? No, not at all. My real issue that's going on right now is all the confusion that it's causing customers. And this is an issue for both 2K and Google, not just one or the other, because they both deserve the blame. I mean, even when they announced this trilogy was an actual thing, for some reason the Stadia logo only appeared on certain versions of the video. And this is something that happens a little too much. I mean, Destroy All Humans, the remake, is coming to Google Stadia. We know that much is clear. And yet, pretty much every trailer for that game doesn't have the Stadia logo at the end, other than the one that the official Stadia channel has posted. Now, this could possibly be because the Stadia version of the game won't be launching side by side for those games, but I honestly don't know, and I would love to get some clarification as to why this is. I've already seen a ton of people confused on whether the game's even coming out to Stadia simply because all the latest trailers no longer showcase the platform. This simply isn't good, not just for the game, but for Stadia as a whole. It really is unnecessary confusion, and while I can understand that maybe the launch trailer has a release date that won't match up with Stadia, is it that hard for Google or the publisher to make the statement that it will be launching sometime afterward? I really don't think so, and it would be totally worth saving people's confusion over said launch. I also want to make it clear, right now I'm just talking about the Stadia logo appearing on trailers, but heck, sometimes it doesn't even appear on the game's website. All of this just adds to the confusion, and I'm sure that it's affecting some users out there who are looking forward to playing the games on Stadia. Ultimately, what this comes down to is that you and I now understand why Mafia didn't release on Stadia day and date with the rest of the platforms, but the general public don't bother to look at things like press releases and are probably very confused. It's a fix that doesn't seem too difficult to solve, so I hope we see it fixed sooner rather than later. Either way, that sums up my thoughts on all of this, but if you have your own opinion, be sure to leave it down in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed this video or found it helpful at all, be sure to hit that like button as it really does help the channel out. And if you're wanting more content like this, be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell as well. Today's end of video message is just going to be a statement. I will be talking about the fact that Serious Sam is coming exclusively to Stadia and not consoles, but I wanted to talk about that in a separate video and give my thoughts more in depth. Expect that video on the channel coming real soon, but for now, I just want to let you know that I'm thankful for all your support. I do appreciate you watching these videos and even these end of video messages. This has been Generation Stadia, giving you that daily dose of everything and anything Stadia related. The Gen S community is over 4,000 strong and growing by the day, and until next time, I'll catch you in the clouds.